Good morning, students. Welcome back. Today we will continue with the chapter first, that is methods of preserving milk and milk products. In the previous video, we have learned about the brief introduction of milk and milk production. Today, children, further we are going to learn about some of the methods for preserving milk and milk products and uses of condensed milk and milk powder. Let's begin, children. The first method is pasteurization. Pasteurization is a process of heating milk to a specific temperature for a predefined length of time and then immediately cooling it after it is removed from heat. Now, children, do you know who discovered the pasteurization of milk? Yeah, Louis Pasteur, a French scientist, discovered the method of pasteurization. Milk obtained from cows or buffaloes is relatively warm. This milk has the ability to absorb microorganisms from the atmosphere. Now, microorganism, it means, children, and organisms that is so small and that one can see it only through a microscope. It is so tiny to see that you require microscope, because microscope enlarges it, makes it looks bigger also. There are microorganisms multiply by cell divisions and cause spoilage of milk. In this process, milk is heated to a temperature of 63 degrees Celsius for at least 30 minutes or 72 degrees Fahrenheit for 15 seconds. Now, children, the advantages of pasteurization. The first advantage is milk retains its flavor even after pasteurization. Retains means, children, to keep or continue to have its own flavor. Second, the quality of milk and milk product is retained. The third one, the shelf life of milk is increased. Shelf life means, children, the period of time during which the food product will remain safe. The next advantage is health of customer is not hampered, means, children, no obstructed bacteria causing gastro, cholera, dysentery, TB, etc. are destroyed through pasteurization. Gastro, it means, children, relating to the stomach problem. Cholera, it means an infection and often fatal bacterial disease of the small intestine, children. TB, it is an extremely serious infectious disease that affects someone's lungs and other parts of their body too. Dysentery, it means, children, infection of intestine resulting in severe diarrhea with the presence of blood. Okay, and the next advantage is milk obtained is pure and nutritious. Next method is, children, drying milk. Milk contains about 81 to 87% water. Milk requires a greater amount of storage. Storage, it means, children, space or place for storing. Due to greater percentage of water, it gets spoiled. Spoiled means, here, children, the taste of milk gets changed. For drying milk, it has to be pasteurized first. About 15% sugar is to be added to the milk and the boil till the content reduces to 1/3 of its volume. Such milk in dried form is called condensed milk. Sweetened condensed milk is very thick, which can last for years without refrigeration if unopened. Khawa made by drying milk can be used for making sweets like pedas, burfis, etc. Next method is children, separation of fats. The fat contained in the milk is removed by the process of centrifugation. The process of centrifugation, it means children, to separate cream from milk. The fat contained in normal milk is about 3 to 4%, whereas the fat contained in milk after separating fats becomes 0.5%. Such milk is called skimmed milk. Skimmed milk is fat-free milk and very easy to digest. It is given to small children, patients, and old people. Now, next method is making milk powder. Milk powder or dried milk is manufactured dairy products made by evaporating milk to dryness. One purpose of drying milk is to preserve it. Milk powder has a longer shelf life than liquid milk and does not need to be refrigerated due to its low moisture content. Shelf life, it means children, here the periods of time during which the food product will remain very safe. Drying of milk is carried out by two methods. The first picture, that is roller drying, and the second picture is spray drying. Roller drying is a method used to dry milk for purposes other than human consumption. Concentrated milk is fed between two heated and narrowly spaced stainless steel rollers and thin film of milk dries as the rollers turn and is scraped off the roller by a doctor blade. Next method, that is spray drying, is a method of producing a dry powder from a liquid or a slurry by rapidly drying with a hot gas. This is the preferred method of drying of many thermally sensitive materials such as foods and pharmaceuticals. Now children, we will see some uses of condensed milk. The first one, sweetened condensed milk is used as a topping on top of a chocolate. Second use is it can be beaten with sugar and butter and baked to make candies also. The third use is it can be used to make coconut laddus, kheer, condensed milk, fudge, etc. It means children, a soft, crumbly or chewy sweets made from sugar, butter and milk or cream. Tasty eggless cake can be made from condensed milk. Unsweetened condensed milk can be used for low calorie recipe for diabetic people. Unsweetened means children, with no sugar or other sweet substances added. Next uses is, it can be used as a healthy dessert dressing over a fruit salad. Healthy dessert, it means children, sugarless and natural. And dressing means children, a sauce for salad. Now, we will see some uses of milk powder. Milk powder is used in the manufacture of infant formula. Secondly, it is used in confectionery such as chocolate and caramel candy. Confectionery, it means children, food items that are rich in sugar and carbohydrates. The next use is, it is used in baking recipes where adding liquid milk would render. It means children, to provide or to give. Next use is, it is widely used for making ice cream. And the next one is, it is used in famous sweets such as Indian milk balls known as gulab jamuns and a popular Indian sweet delicacy known as chum chum. Now it's time for recap, children, what we have learned in this lesson so far. Yeah, we have learned first, that is a brief introduction about milk and milk production. Second, we have studied about the sum of the methods for preserving milk and milk products. We have also done the uses of condensed milk and milk powder. Students, I hope you enjoyed the lesson. Thank you. Stay safe.